In this class, we are going to discuss about the mechanism of a reaction. That is a reaction mechanism. Okay? Now, according to the reaction mechanism, there are two types of chemical reactions. That means reactions are divided into two types. Number one, elementary reactions, simple reactions, or single step reactions. Elementary reactions, nothing but simple reaction, nothing but single step reaction. Whereas number two, complex reactions or multi-step reactions. Okay, now what are the elementary reactions? Those reactions in which the reaction occurs only in the one step. That means these reactions are completed in a one step reaction. These reactions are completed in a one step or a single step. Like we have in organic chemistry, SN2 mechanism, which is a concerted mechanism, and E2 elimination, which is also a concerted mechanism, which occurs only in the one step or a single step process. Okay, and in this reaction there will be no any formation of intermediate. This is very important. In one step reaction or a single step reaction or a elementary reaction, there will be no any formation of intermediate. Like in organic chemistry, we know various types of intermediates like carbocation, carbanion, carbon free radical, nitrene, carbene. These are some reaction intermediates. These reaction intermediates are short-lived species. During the course of a chemical reaction, they form, okay, before the completion of reaction, they will be disappear in the system. That's why they are called reaction intermediates. These reaction intermediates are highly unstable. Okay, now if you see the example of number one, ammonium nitrate. In this reaction, ammonium nitrate decomposes to give nitrogen gas and H2O. This is a one step reaction or a single step reaction or a elementary reaction. In the similar fashion, HI decomposition to give hydrogen and iodine. Next to nitric oxide reaction with ozone to give nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. Number 4, nitric oxide get oxidized to give nitrogen dioxide. These reactions are referred as which reactions? Elementary reactions. What are elementary reactions? Those reactions which occur in a single step reaction or one step reaction. Are you getting my point? Now in this, if you see the energy profile diagram, on the x-axis progress of the reaction, and on the y-axis potential energy of the system. If you plot a graph between potential energy versus reaction progress. Now these are the reactants. So the energy of reactants ER and energy of the products will be EP. Okay. Now here there is a transition state. This is the highest energy of the barrier. Okay. Now here there will be no any intermediate formation occurs. This is the elementary reaction. Okay, elementary reactions, there is only one step, and hence this is known as a rate determining step. Rate determining step is also called RDS, rate controlling step. We will discuss. Okay, now complex reactions. What are complex reactions? These reactions in which more than one step, those reactions which occurs in more than one step are called complex reactions. Otherwise, those reactions which occur multi-step, those reactions which involve multi-step reactions, more than one reaction will be present. Okay, in multi-step involves there will be a formation of reaction intermediates. There will be a formation of what? Reaction intermediates. Okay, now here the energy profile diagram, if you see, on the x-axis there is a progress of the reaction, progress of reaction, on the y-axis potential energy of the system. Now this is the highest energy transition state, this is the second transition state. Let's suppose this is the transition state 1, this will be the transition state 2, and between these two there is a lower peak which is called intermediate, which is known as what? Intermediate. Okay. Now these complex reactions occur in more than one step, and each step is known as a elementary reaction. Now each step in a complex reaction, just now I told you what? Elementary reaction. Now if you observe, the carbon monoxide oxidation by nitrogen dioxide to give carbon dioxide and nitric oxide. Now if you see this reaction, looking very simple reaction, but it is a complex reaction, because in this reaction there are two steps involved. In the first step, what happens? Nitrogen dioxide and nitrogen dioxide combined to give nitric oxide and nitrogen trioxide. This nitrogen trioxide, it is neither a reactant, that means it is not on the left hand side of the arrow notation, or it is not a product, that is it is not on the right hand side. That's why this NO3 is known as a reaction intermediate. This NO3 is known as a reaction intermediate. This is a highly unstable species. Reaction intermediates are highly unstable. Okay. In the second step, carbon monoxide combined with nitrogen trioxide to give carbon dioxide and nitrogen dioxide. If you combining these two reactions, then the NO3 gets cancelled. Are you getting my point? Now you will get the final reaction. If you see here also, NO2 gets cancelled. Overall in the final reaction, you will get the NO2 plus CO gives NO plus CO2. Similarly, example number 2, 2NO2 plus F2 gives 2NO2F. It also having the two step process. In the step 1, NO2 plus F2 gives NO2F plus F. This F is a nascent fluorine. Okay, this process is a slow process. And the second step, NO2 plus nascent fluorine combined to give NO2F. This is a fast step. If you add these two reactions, step, you will get the overall reaction, that is NO2, that is the NO2 plus NO2, 2NO2 plus F2 gives NO2F plus NO2F, that is 2NO2F. Similarly, third example, that is the decomposition of ozone. It is also complex reaction which involves two steps. In the first step, O3 decomposes to give O2 and nascent oxygen atom. This O3 again combined with the nascent oxygen atom to give O2. First step is the fast step and second one is the slow step. If you add these two reactions, overall you will get the 2O3 gives 3O2. What is the mechanism? What is the reaction mechanism or mechanism of reaction? A series of step reactions or elementary reactions proposed to account for the overall reaction is called reaction mechanism. That means a series of elementary reactions are proposed to explain the overall reaction. Such phenomena is known as a mechanism of the reaction. That is the series of step reactions or elementary reactions proposed to account for the overall reaction is known as a reaction mechanism. Let's suppose I have reactant initially, capital A. When reactant react to give B, and which further react to give C, and finally which will give the product to D. Okay. Now here A to D, if you observe, there are two intermediates will be formed, B and C. So this is the B and this is the C, and these two refer as a reaction intermediates. Reaction intermediates. Now from A to B, this is the first step, this is the first elementary reaction. From B to C, this will be the second step, this is the second elementary reaction. And C to D, this is the third step, this is the third elementary reaction. A sequential arrangement of elementary reactions to give overall reaction, this phenomena is known as a mechanism of reaction or reaction mechanism. Okay. Now, what is the definition of a rate determining step, or it is known as a RDS? Most of the reactions occur more than one elementary step mechanism, more than one elementary step mechanism. One of these steps often is much slower than the other steps. That means, let's suppose we have A to B, B to C, C to D. We have how many steps here? Three steps. Out of the three steps, let's suppose step 2 is a very slow process, whereas step 1 is very fast and step 3 is also very fast. So in a complex reaction, more than one elementary steps are present. Out of these three elementary steps, any one step which occurs very slow rate, that is called slow reaction, very slow reaction. Okay, in this very slow reaction only we can determine the rate of the reaction. That's why that process, that slow step is called rate determining step. It is also called rate controlling step. Rate controlling step. Are you getting my point? So here the overall rate of the reaction cannot exceed the rate of the slowest step. This is very important. That means the overall reaction rate cannot exceed the rate of the slowest step. That's why this slowest step, what happens, it will control, it will limit the rate of the overall reaction. That's why it is also known as a rate determining step or slowest step or rate controlling step. Now the next one is the molecularity of a reaction. This is a very important topic regarding the competitive examination, even board exam also. What is the definition of a molecularity? It is a number of reacting species. The reacting species may be atoms, may be molecules, may be ions. That means it is the number of reacting species that must collide simultaneously with each other in an elementary reaction to bring a chemical reaction. Are you getting my point? This is a very important definition. Once again, I am repeating, it is the number of atoms, ions, molecules that must collide with each other simultaneously in an elementary step, that is a slow step, in order to bring a chemical reaction. Generally, in a chemical reaction, what happens? The reacting molecules, what they do? They collide with each other. During this collision, what happens? Old bonds has to be break down and new bonds has to be formed. Are you getting my point? Now, in an elementary step, that is a slow step of a reaction, how many number of atoms or molecules or ions simultaneously collide with each other to perform a reaction, to bring a chemical reaction, that number is known as a molecularity of a reaction. Molecularity of a reaction can be deduced from the reaction mechanism. How we can know the molecularity? With the help of the reaction mechanism. It is always a whole number. This is very important. Whole number means 1, 2, 3, like that. Okay. Now, it cannot be 0. This is also important. And it cannot be fractional value. So, molecularity never 0. That means 0 molecule and fractional value. That means 0.5, 1.5, 2.2, 2.3. These values are not possible for the molecularity. Molecularity values, if they are 1, 2, 3, then the reactions are called unimolecular reactions and bimolecular reactions and trimolecular reactions. If the molecularity of a reaction is 1, that is called unimolecular reaction. If the molecularity is 2, that is bimolecular. If the molecularity is 3, that is called trimolecular reaction. We know in organic chemistry, SN2 reaction, that is called bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction, whereas SN1 reaction, that is called unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Similarly, we know E2 bimolecular elimination reaction, unimolecular elimination reaction, E1 reaction. So here, molecularity, more than 3 reactions are very rare reactions and they are proceed very difficultly, because the probability of simultaneously colliding with each other more than 3 molecules are very difficult. Simultaneously, that means, let's suppose if I have 2 molecules, let's suppose these are the 2 molecules which are in a spherical shape. So these 2 molecules are collisions, that means these are called binary collisions. Okay. Now let's suppose one more molecule is there, let us suppose 3 molecules are there. So 3 molecules are simultaneously colliding. This is called trimolecular collision. So these 3 molecules will be in the same plane. Okay. Let's suppose if you see the fourth molecule, if the fourth molecule is also allowed to collision, then it is not possible at a time all these 4 molecules to collide simultaneously, because if you take the fourth molecule, the fourth molecule will be either above the plane or below the plane only. Are you getting my point? That means the chances, the probability to collision simultaneously, okay, more than three molecules, very difficult. That's why the molecularity greater than three reactions are very rare, very rare. Molecularity one, that is called unimolecular reaction. Best example, ammonium nitrate decomposition, HI decomposition to give H2 and I2. This is a bimolecular reaction, that is the molecularity 2. And 2NO plus O2 gives 2NO2, that is called molecularity 3. That's why this is called molecularity 3. This is called unimolecular reaction. The second example is called bimolecular reaction. And third example is called trimolecular reaction. In generally, for any elementary reaction, molecularity and order will be equal to the stoichiometric coefficient of the reactant. This is a very important statement. For which reaction? Elementary reaction. In elementary reaction, in the elementary reaction, if you see the molecularity as well as the order, both are equal to the stoichiometric coefficient of the reactants. Now here two reactants are there, A and B, and their stoichiometric coefficients are small a and small b. So the sum of the A and B will be equal to molecularity. Otherwise, if you want to write the order, it is also same. That means for elementary reactions, that is single step reaction, order and molecularity both are equal. Order and molecularity will be both are equal. Now order is applicable to elementary reactions as well as complex reactions, okay? But whereas molecularity is applicable only for elementary reactions, for complex reactions which occurs in more than one step, there is no any meaning. There will be no any meaning for complex reactions. For complex reactions, order is given by the slowest step. In a complex reaction which occurs in a more than one step, out of which only one step which will be occurs with slow rate, that is called slowest step. So for complex reaction, order is decided by which step? Slowest step. And molecularity of the slowest step is same as order for the overall reaction, is same as the order for the overall reaction. Now there are some differences between order and molecularity. So this question is a very important question. Are you getting my point? Now what are the differences between order and molecularity? First of all, the basic definition of order and molecularity. What is the order? Sum of the powers of the concentration terms of the rate expression is called order of the reaction. Okay. What is the molecularity? Just now we explained, it is the number of atoms, molecules or ions that are simultaneously colliding with each other to bring a chemical reaction. Now we know order may be positive, may be negative, may be zero, even fractional value. But molecularity is always a whole number, that is 1, 2, 3. And one more important thing, molecularity cannot be zero and also fractional value. Are you getting my point? But order may be zero, order may be fractional value, order may be negative value, order may be positive value. Order is determined experimentally. How order is determined? Experimentally. What about the molecularity? Molecularity was deduced from the reaction mechanism. Reaction mechanism. Now, the order is applicable to elementary reactions, that means one step reaction, as well as complex reactions. But whereas molecularity is applicable to elementary reactions. Just now I told you there is no any meaning for complex reactions, because complex reactions have more than one step. So each step has its own molecularity. In a complex reaction, each individual elementary reaction has its own molecularity. Are you getting my point? It has no meaning of complex reaction. It has only significant to the slow step of the complex reaction. And molecularity of the slowest step is the same as overall order of the reaction. Just now I told you, molecularity of the slowest step is same as overall order of the reaction regarding a complex reaction. Are you getting my point? Now, order, it is defined for whole reaction. Total reaction we can define for order. But molecularity cannot be defined for total reaction. it will be defined for each step of the reaction, each step of the reaction. Okay, now order of reaction can be less than the molecularity of the reaction, whereas molecularity of a reaction cannot be less than the order of a reaction. Are you getting my point? That means the order value may be less than molecularity, but molecularity cannot be less than the order value. That means molecularity may be equal to order or may be greater than the order, but the molecularity never be less than the order. Are you getting my point? Now here some problems are given. Question number 91. What is the question number 91? Gas phase decomposition of N2O is given. Step 1 given, N2O gives N2 plus O. And step 2 given, N2O plus O gives N2 plus O2. Step 1 is the slow and step 2 is the fast. Now the question is, write the overall reaction. Number 1, what is the molecularity of the each of the elementary reaction? Number 3, identify the reaction intermediate. Okay. Now here, if you add equation 1 and 2, what is the equation 1? N2O gives what? N2 plus O. That is the nascent oxygen. In the second step, N2O plus nascent oxygen to give what? N2 plus O2. If you add these two equations, the net equation will be, you will get what? N2O plus N2O, 2N2O to give N2 plus N2. That is called 2N2 plus O2. So this is called overall reaction. This is the first question. Now the second question, what is the molecularity of the each of the elementary? So this is the step one, how many species are there? N2O. That means step one is unimolecular reaction. What about the step two? In step two, if you see, there are two species, number one N2O, number two nascent oxygen. That's why it is a bimolecular reaction. Step two is what? Bimolecular. Just now I told you, the molecularity, each step has its own molecularity. Okay, so this is the second question. So this is the first question. Now come to the third question. What is the reaction intermediate here? Nascent oxygen. Nascent oxygen is reaction intermediate. Reaction intermediate. Are you getting my point? Now come to question number 92. What is the question number 92? The reaction 2NO2 Cl gives 2NO2 plus Cl2. Rate expression is given as R is equal to K times of NO2 Cl concentration. Then write the mechanism. Yes. Now whenever the rate expression is given, first of all write the rate expression R is equal to K times of the NO2 Cl concentration. Are you getting my point? Now here, what is the equation given to you? NO2 Cl. How many moles given? 2 moles given. Let's suppose I am taking first step. In the first step, I am using 1 mole of NO2 Cl. So when 1 mole of NO2 Cl decomposes to give NO2 and Cl. Are you getting my point? Now in the step 2, I am using the second mole of the reactant, that is called NO2 Cl. And here if you observe, what is the reaction intermediate? Elementary chlorine. If you see, nascent chlorine, not elementary, nascent chlorine. Because this nascent chlorine, it is neither on the right hand side nor on the left hand side. That's why Cl is the reaction intermediate. Once NO2 Cl combined with Cl to give NO2 Cl2, NO2 plus Cl2. Are you getting my point? If you add these two reactions, you will get the overall reaction. Are you getting my point? Now here, out of these two steps, which step is a slow step? The first step will be the slow step, because in the rate expression, if you see in the rate expression, which concentration is involving? NO2 Cl concentration is involving. That's why the first step is the slow step and second step is the fast step. Okay, suppose if the question is given in the reverse direction, that means step 1, step 2, 2 steps are given, then write the rate expression. Immediately, rate is applicable to slow step of the reaction. Now, what is the slow step here? First step. In the first step, what is the reacting species? NO2Cl. So R is equal to K times of NO2Cl concentration. This is the rate law expression, rate law equation. Are you getting my point? Now come to question number 93. What is the question number 93 here? 2NO plus Br2 gives 2NO Br. Okay. Here two steps given, step 1, step 2 given. Step 1 is the fast step and step 2 will be the slow step. Now here we can write the rate expression only for step slow step. So I am using the slow step, that is the step 2. R is equal to K into NO Br2 concentration multiplied by NO concentration. Are you getting my point? Let's suppose this will be the equation number 1. Do you know NOBr2, it is an intermediate, because NOBr2, it is neither in the reactant side nor in the product side. So what I am trying to do here, I have to remove this intermediate. So I have to convert this intermediate in terms of reactants. So from step 1, so this expression is coming from, equation 1 is coming from step, equation 1 is coming from step 2. From step 1, there is an equilibrium, fast step, so that's why I am using some equilibrium constant, K equilibrium, nothing but the concentration of the products divided by concentration of the reactants. There are two reactants are there, NO and Br2. Are you getting my point? From here, what is the concentration of NO Br2? The concentration of NO Br2 shall write cross multiplication K equilibrium into concentration of NO into concentration of Br2. Okay, now this is the equation number 2. Now equation number 2, put the equation 2 in equation number 1, you will get R is equal to K times of NO Br2. From NO Br2, from equation number 2, shall I put the K equilibrium into concentration of NO into concentration of Br2 and concentration of NO. Are you getting my point? Now here there is a another equilibrium, there is a another constant, because K is a constant, equilibrium constant is also constant, so that's why I am using another constant K. Okay, now NO into NO, NO whole square into Br2. So this is the rate law. Are you getting my point? That means with respect to NO2, second order kinetics, and with respect to Br2, first order kinetics, and overall this is a third order kinetics. Are you getting my point? Question number 94, 2a plus b gives products, follows the mechanism. So here also two steps are given, first step is a fast step. So I am using first step. First step is which step? In the question given fast step. So I am using the equilibrium constant, K equilibrium is equal to concentration of A2 divided by concentration of A2, concentration of A2, concentration of A, concentration of A whole square. Are you getting my point? Concentration of A whole square. Are you getting my point? From here, shall I write the concentration of A2, because A2 is a reaction intermediate, in terms of equilibrium constant and in terms of concentration of the reactants. Let's suppose this will be the equation number 1. From step 2, which is a slow step, that is given in the question. So we can apply the rate expression, that is R is equal to K into concentration of A2 into concentration of B. Are you getting my point? A2 is a reaction intermediate, that's why it should be converted into concentration of reactants. So that's why I am taking R is equal, instead of A2, I am writing equilibrium constant, K equilibrium into concentration of A whole square into concentration of B. So here there is a another constant I am using, R is equal to, so these two are constant, so there is a one more constant into concentration of A whole square multiplied by concentration of B, concentration of B. That means here overall it is a which order kinetics? Third order kinetics, because order with respect to A 2 and order with respect to B 1. So overall it is which order kinetics? Third order kinetics. So the order of a reaction will be the option C, that is the third order kinetics. Option C, that is the third order kinetics. Are you getting my point? Now here, next question. Question number 95. In this question number 95, a reaction A2 gives A plus A. This is a fast reaction. So from the fast reaction, let's suppose this is the first step. Step 1. Otherwise, first step. In the first step, we apply the equilibrium. K equilibrium will be equal to accelerate A into A divided by A 2 concentration. So this is nothing but A into A square divided by A 2 concentration. From here, accelerate the concentration of A will be equal to under root of equilibrium constant and under root of A 2 concentration. Okay, let's suppose this will be equation 1. Now from second step, second reaction, if you see, this is a slow process. In this slow process, shall I apply the rate expression? R is equal to K times of A into B2. What is the A? That will be a intermediate. So that will be converted into, in terms of reactant, in terms of A2. So from equation 1, instead of concentration of A, shall I take the under root of K equilibrium constant into under root of A2 concentration? Okay. Under root of A2 concentration. Now into concentration of B2. So this will be the new constant. So that's why I am changing the new constant. That is R is equal to some other constant K into concentration of A2 to the power 1 by 2 and concentration B2 to the power 1. So overall, if you observe 1 plus 1 by 2, that means order with respect to B 1 and order with respect to half. So overall order will be 3 by 2. That means overall order is equal to 1 plus 1 by 2. That is called 3 by 2. That is called 1.5. Are you getting my point? Now come to question number 96. 3ClO minus gives ClO3 plus 2Cl minus. The rate expression is given. What is the rate expression is given? R is equal to K times of the ClO minus whole square. Now the question is, write the mechanism. So initially, how many moles of reactant is there? 3 moles of reactant is there. Okay. Now I am taking 2 moles of reactant, that is 2ClO minus will give to you ClO2 minus plus Cl minus. This is the first step. Out of the 3 moles, I already used 2 moles of reactant. There will be one more reactant will be left, that is the ClO minus. And ClO2 minus, that is the intermediate that should be decomposed here. So overall, if you see, you will get ClO3 minus plus Cl minus. Are you getting my point? The first step is the slow step. And second step will be the fast. Why I am writing the first step slow? Because the stoichiometry will be 2. Here the exponent will be 2. That means only the rate is applicable to slow step of the reaction. That is the, in the elementary reaction, the stoichiometry will be equal to the order of the reaction. Are you getting my point? So if you add these two reactions, overall reaction you will get 3ClO minus gives rise to ClO3 minus plus 2Cl minus. So this is the step 1 and this will be the step 2. So this is the mechanism of the reaction. Are you getting my point? Now come to question number 97. In this 97 question, here 2H2O2 gives 2H2O. 2H2O2 gives 2H2O plus O2. 2H2O plus what? O2. Are you getting my point? Now here, in this reaction, I minus is there, iodide ion is there, and the reaction medium is alkaline medium. And the rate expression is given what? Rate is equal to K times of H2O2 concentration. Rate is equal to K times of H2O2 concentration multiplied by I minus concentration. This is given in the question. Okay. Now, write the mechanism. Write the mechanism. First of all, what I am writing, how many moles of reactant is there? 2 moles. Okay. Now here I am using only 1 mole because in the rate expression, if you see H2O2 to the power is 1. And I have to use I minus ion also, because I minus ion is also involving in the rate expression. So H2O2 combining with I minus 2 give H2O plus IO minus. It is the first step. In the second step, one mole reactant is there, that is H2O2. Now here IO minus is a intermediate that has to be decomposed. Okay. Now to give H2O plus O2 plus I minus. If you add these two reactions, finally you will get the overall reaction H2O2 plus H2O2, 2H2O2. And here IO minus gets cancelled, I minus gets cancelled. Finally, you will get the answer 2H2O plus O2. Are you getting my point? Now, in these two steps, which is a slow step and which is a fast step? The first step, which I am writing here, H2O2 plus I minus, this is the slow step. Why I am writing the slow step? Because H2O2 and I minus both are participating in the rate expression. That's why I am using the first step as a slow step and second step as a fast step. Are you getting my point? Question number 97. Next to question number 98. For the reaction 2H2 plus 2NO gives N2 plus 2H2O, the following mechanism has suggested 2NO equilibrium N2O2 equilibrium constant K1 N2O2 plus H2 gives N2O plus H2O slow the rate of the reaction K2, and N2O plus H2 gives N2 plus H2O fast the rate of the reaction is the K3. Establish the rate expression. Are you getting my point? Mechanism is given, we have to write the rate expression. Okay, now here question number 98, the answer, what is the first equilibrium constant? K1. What is the equilibrium constant? Concentration of the products divided by the concentration of the reactants. Product will be what? N2O2. What is the reactant here? NO. Stoichiometry will be 2, so that will be raised to the power. Are you getting my point? Now, the slow step is there. From the slow step, we can apply the rate law. Yes, R is equal to shell rate K times of N2O2 multiplied by H2. The rate constant is given K2, so I am writing K2. Now R is equal to K2 instead of N2O2. What is N2O2? Reaction intermediate. Shell rate concentration of N2O2 is equal to K1 times of the concentration of NO whole square. Now instead of N2O2, I am using K1 into concentration of NO whole square multiplied by H2. Now K1, K2 both are constant, that's why I am using another constant, some K into NO whole square into H2 to the power 1. So this is the overall rate law expression. Are you getting my point? In this rate law expression, if you see order with respect to nitric oxide, second order, and order with respect to dihydrogen, first order, and total order will be 2 plus 1, that is the third order reaction. Are you getting my point? Now come to the question number 99. In this question number 99, the reaction of formation of fuzzing from CO plus Cl2 is CO plus Cl2 gives CoCl2. The proposed mechanism, here there are how many steps given here? 3 steps given. First step, Cl2 gives 2Cl. Fast, that is equilibrium. K1, K minus 1, that is the forward, backward, that is the rate of the reaction. K1, rate constant for forward, K minus 1, backward reaction. Second reaction given, Cl plus CO gives CoCl. Forward reaction, K2, backward reaction, K minus 2. And third reaction, CoCl plus Cl2 gives K3, gives CoCl2 plus Cl, slow reaction. Now, out of these three, the third step is the slow step, which is applicable for rate law. Now, we have to show that the rate law expression, that is d by dt of CoCl2 is equal to K times of CO into Cl2 to the power 3 by 2, where the K value will be equal to K3 into K2 by K minus 2. Into K1 by K minus 1 whole to the power 1 by 2. Are you getting my point? Now first of all, What is the first step given in the question? What is the first step given in the question? That is Cl2 gives 2Cl. So what is the equilibrium constant? That is the rate constant for forward reaction K1, backward reaction K minus 1 will be equal to concentration of the products, that is the Cl, are you getting my point? To the Cl concentration is here, power 2 divided by Cl2. Are you getting my point? From here, if you want to write the concentration of Cl only, then you can write Cl concentration by Cl2 concentration to the power 1 by 2, which will be equal to K1 upon K minus 1 to the power under root. Shall I write like this? Are you getting my point? If you squaring on both sides, again you will get Cl whole square by Cl2 will equal to K1 by K minus 1. Are you getting my point? Now what is the second equilibrium constant here? This is the second equilibrium. This will be the first equilibrium. What is the second equilibrium equation 2? Rate constant for forward K2 by reverse K minus 2, which is equal to concentration of COCl upon concentration of CO multiplied by Cl. Are you getting my point? Now what is the third equation that is applicable to rate law? What is the rate law here? COCl plus Cl2 to give what? COCl2 plus Cl. So this is given as a slow step. So now what I am doing, I am applying the rate law for the slow step of the reaction. R is equal to, what is the rate constant value given here? K3. So I am using R is equal to K3 into concentration of COCl multiplied by concentration of Cl2. Are you getting my point? Now I am writing R is equal to K3 into, okay, instead of COCl, from here shall write K2 upon K minus 2 concentration of CO into concentration of Cl, okay, into concentration of Cl2. In the next step, what I am writing, R is equal to, I am writing K3 into K2 upon K minus 2 into concentration of CO into what is the concentration of Cl. From here, shall I write the concentration of Cl equal to, shall I write the Cl2 concentration to the power 1 by 2, K1 by K minus 1 to the power 1 by 2. So first of all, I am writing K1 by K minus 1 to the power 1 by 2. Okay. Now, Cl2 and Cl2 to the power 1 by 2. Are you getting my point? Now here R is equal to overall what I am writing here, K3 into K2 by K minus 2 and K1 by K minus 1 to the power 1 by 2. Now what I am writing, concentration of CO into concentration of Cl2 to the power 1 plus 1 by 2, that is 3 by 2. So all these constants put together, I am taking another constant, let's suppose that will be the K, okay, into concentration of CO multiplied by concentration of Cl2 to the power 3 by 2. So this is the overall rate law expression. So here the K value, that will be the K3 into K2 by K minus 2 into K1 by K minus 1 whole to the power 1 by 2. Okay. One more last question is there. The decomposition of ozone proceeds as O3 equilibrium. First step is the equilibrium. So O3 gives what? O2 plus O. This is a fast step. So from equilibrium, shall I apply the equilibrium constant is equal to product of the concentration of the products divided by the reactants. Do you know here nascent oxygen is a reaction intermediate? That's why I am writing nascent oxygen concentration will be equal to equilibrium constant multiplied by the concentration of O3 divided by the concentration of O2. Okay. Now the second expression given, slow step, that is the O plus O3. What is the second step? O plus O3 to give what? 2O2. This is slow step. So in the slow step we can apply the rate law. Yes, what is the rate law here? R is equal to K times of concentration of O into concentration of O3. Now what is the nascent oxygen concentration from in this expression? K equilibrium into concentration of O3 upon concentration of O2 into again concentration of O3. So here K rate constant, K equilibrium constant, the product of these two will be another constant. Let's suppose there is another K, okay, into O3 concentration to the power 2 into O2 concentration to the power minus 1. Now if you see in this expression, order with respect to ozone, second order, order with respect to oxygen, minus 1. Do you know order may be positive, order may be negative, order may be 0, even order may be fractional value also. So the question, rate law expression, okay. Now if the question is given overall order, what is the answer for overall order? This is a first order. Overall order is the first order. Order with respect to ozone, second order, with respect to oxygen, minus 1 order. So with respect to ozone, second order, with respect to oxygen, minus 1 order. So that's why the option will be the second option, okay? I don't care what you got to.